We are going to study about the life history of Legionella, which is a well-known pteridophyte. We are focusing on the gametophytic development of this pteridophyte. Here we have this overview of the entire life cycle of Legionella, which includes this strobilus, through which we get our microsporangium and megasporangium, which further gives microspore and megaspore, through which on germinating we get male gametophyte and female gametophyte, which gives eggs and sperm, which further fuses and undergoes fertilization, and we get our zygote, and then through zygote a developing sporophyte is there, and the further process goes on. So Legionella reproduces vegetatively and by spores. In vegetative reproduction, Legionella reproduces vegetatively by the help of tubers, bulbils, and dormant buds, and by fragmentation. Now, reproduction by spores. We know that Legionella is a heterosporous pteridophyte, so it produces two types of spores. First one is megaspore and the other one is microspore. Megaspores form female gametophytes on germination, and the microspores forms male gametophytes. The sporangia bearing microspores are called microsporangia, and the other megaspores are called megasporangia. Gametophytic generation. It is haploid. It depends on sporophyte. It consists of development of male and female gametophyte, and then the fusion of egg and sperm. It includes mega and microspores. Microspores are small, spherical. Here it is a diameter, and they contain two layers, intine and exine. And the megaspores are larger, tetrahedral shaped, and they are larger than the microspores. They have triradiate ridges and they are trilayered. That is, they have three layers. First one is exospore, the middle one is mesospore, and the inner one is endospore. Development of male gametophyte. It starts from the microspore. The first unequal division occurs and we get a sterile prothelial cell and an enthridial initial. The sterile prothelial cell undergoes no division, and the rest of the divisions are concerned to only enthridial cell. Then oblique wall division occurs and we get our first Jekyll cell. Then other periclinal division occurs and we get other two Jekyll cells, the third Jekyll cells from further division, and the fourth Jekyll cells. And finally we have our antherozoids, which are biflagellated spiral uninucleate, which are released by the rupture of exine and intine and are free to swim and reach female gamete by swimming in water. Development of female gametophyte. It starts when the megaspore is still inside the megasporangium. From megasporangium, we get four megaspores, out of which three degenerates and only one is functional. They have triradiate ridges. The exospore starts dividing so rapidly in comparison to the mesospore and endospore. The nucleus divides by free nuclear divisions, and this forms large number of nuclei which are distributed in cytoplasm, but later on apical portion they get accumulated. The apical cellular part is known as female prothallus, and the lower non-cellular part is called storage region. Here we can see this division and the free nuclei, the large vacuole. The vacuole disappears because of the last cytoplasm, and the female gametophyte flagrates from the sporangium and then falls on a suitable substratum, which germinates and the axine and mesine ruptures. The cellular tissues protrudes out and forms rhizoids, which help through the fixation to the substratum and absorption of water. Development of archegonium. Few cells near the apex of female prothallus, we get this archegonial initial, which undergoes transverse divisions and form primary cover cell and lower central cell, which undergoes two vertical divisions, which are right angle to each other and forms four cells. And these cells undergo another transverse divisions and form neck of two tiers of four cells each. The central cell undergoes transverse division and forms upper primary neck canal cell and lower primary venter cell, which for further division and forms single neck canal cell and ventral canal cell plus an egg cell. Mature archegonium is short, flask-shaped, embedded in female gametophytic tissue. The upper tier projects out. Four cells of upper tier of neck are called as cover cells, and the neck encloses neck canal cell and venter canal cell and an egg cell. At maturity, neck canal cell and the venter canal cell disorganizes and absorbs large amount of water, which creates a pressure to separate apart cover cells. And thus the enterozoids finally enter the archegonium and reach the egg. Fertilization. It is carried out with the help of water. The enterozoids by swimming reach the egg and fuses with egg nucleus and forms a zygotic nucleus that secretes a wall around it. And then we get our zygote, or also known as oospores. Here the gametophytic generation ends, and the initiation of sporophytic generation is started. Embryo development. The oospore and or the zygote, it undergoes first transverse division and forms suspensor initial or upper epivasal or and embryo initial, also called lower hypobasal cell, which helps to thrust the development of embryo deep into female gametophytic tissues to absorb food. The hypobasal or embryo initial undergoes two vertical divisions, which are right angle to each other and forms a four cells called quadrant. One out of these four divides by oblique wall and forms a shoot initial. Rest of the cells divide transversely, forming two tiers of four cells each. By further divisions, it forms multicellular structure and makes foot, rhizophore, ligule, stem, cotyledons. And then the beginning of young sporophytic generation comes. Thank you for watching this video.